Good morning, student. Dear student, welcome back. Online webinar classes, which is conducted by the Trice Society, Hyderabad. This is Mahipal Reddy, PGT Mathematics, Pedapur Camp. So, continuous class of the yesterday, Chapter 6 of Maths 2B, Integration. So, we have completed the two classes in the day, yesterday and day before yesterday. So, today is the third day. So of the integration, before going to third day, so we have to recapitulation what we learned in the yesterday recapitulation. So we learned integration by substitution method. In that integration of algebraic functions, method of substitution. So we solved some problems which involves the algebraic functions by method of substitution. Next, integration of trigonometric functions by method of substitution. So that means we don't have the standard form of the integration of tan x, integration of cot x, integration of secant x, and integration of cosecant x. So yesterday we solved those problems by using the substitution method. Now today we are going to learn third day. Today is a day 3. Today we are going to learn integration by substitution method, evaluation of integrals of algebraic functions of special forms. So some problems involves the special forms, so we can't solve the directly by using the standard forms, and we can't solve by the using the another method. We can solve by substitution method, which is also included special forms. And exercise 6B also we are going to learn today. So evaluation of integrals of algebraic functions of special forms. Example 1, show that integration 1 by x square plus a square, integration 1 by x square plus a square dx equals to, we have to show that it is equals to 1 by a tan inverse of x by a, 1 by a tan inverse of x by a plus c. So we have to show that it is a special form is there. Integration 1 by x square plus a square into dx equals to 1 by a of tan inverse of x by a plus c. How we can look at here? Solution, what is the LHS is here? Integration x square, integration 1 by x square plus a square into dx. Dear student, look at here. I am taking in the denominator a square common. So when it is taken, the a square is common. So it is denominator become 1 plus a square into 1 plus x square by a square. Integration 1 by x square plus a square into dx can be changed as it is equals to integration. We are taking the a square common 1 by a square into 1 plus x square by a square into dx. Let it is equation number 1. Let what I am taking is here x by a. X by a I am taking is here t. X by a I am taking is here t. So derivative with respect to x on both sides. Derivative with respect to x on both sides. What is become when it is derivative? So it become, now look at here. X by a, derivative is 1 by a with respect to x. It is equals to dt. T derivative with respect to x variable. It is equals to dt by dx. So carry the dx to the left side and send the a to the right side. So dx we can write is equals to a into dt, a into dt. So therefore equation one implies integration 1 by, actually what is equation 1? Integration 1 by a square into 1 plus x square by a square into dx equals to, I am writing denominator a square is outside, 1 by a square, integration 1 by 1 plus x square by a square can be written as x by a whole square into dx. x by a into v square. Look at the children, what you have taken x by a, this value is taken is here t, and dx we got is here, dx we got here a into dt. Okay, so it is transformed into, look at how it is transformed here, it is equals to 1 by a square integration 1 by 1 plus t square, 1 by t square. So one integration, and I'm writing the a is outside, a into dt, you can write the a outside, integration 1 by 1 plus t square into dt. Dear student, look at here how it is formed, but we have the formula, standard formula, integration 1 by 1 plus x square dx equals to tan inverse of x. So tan inverse of x. So this is now, what is become now? It is now tan inverse of t, tan inverse of t. And here a get cancelled. So what is the remaining is here? 1 by a into tan inverse of t. So 1 by a into tan inverse of t plus c. But what is the t value here? T value we are choosing here, x by a equals to t. So substitute the t value is x by a. Therefore, the solution is 1 by a into tan inverse of x by a plus c. Therefore, hence proved. What is the therefore? Integration 1 by x square plus a square into dx equals to 1 by a tan inverse of x by a plus c. Hence proved. Dear student, this is important. We can use this as a formula by solving the problems in the next coming exercise. So therefore, integration 1 by x square plus a square into dx equals to 1 by a tan inverse of x by a plus c. Let us go to the another example to show that integration 1 by x square minus a square, 1 by x square minus a square into dx equals to 1 by 2a log of x minus a by x plus a, log of x minus a by x plus a plus c. This is also important standard form. We can use as a standard form. So dear student, already in the math 2a, you are already learned partial fractions are there, partial fraction method. So this problem we can solve by partial fraction method. Let 1 by x square minus a square can be written as x minus a into x plus a. Look at this. This is the non-repeated linear factors. So we have the some methods are there in the partial fraction. This is the first method. So it is a x square minus a square can be written as x minus a into x plus a. That's why. So we can, this is a method one, we can write this as a by x minus a plus b by x plus a by x minus a plus b by x plus a. So it is equals to, now when you take the LCM on the left, on the right side, LCM on the right side is x square minus a square. Then the numerator become a into x plus a plus b into x minus a. Take the LCM here. Now LCM is x minus a, x square minus a square. Then a into x plus a plus b into x minus a. After simplification, we can get his there. Both side denominator get cancelled because both side denominator same, x square minus a square. So denominator get cancelled. So now numerator is also equal. What is the numerator here? A into x plus a plus b into x minus a equals to 1. That is equation number 1. Look at here. Already we solved this type of problems in the partial fraction. Let x equals to a. If x equals to a, then a into a plus a plus b into a minus a equals to 1. So a plus a is the 2a. So capital A into 2a plus b into a minus a is the 0. A minus a is the 0. Therefore, 2 into a into 2a plus b into 0 equals to 1. From that, what is the capital A value is? 1 by 2a. Capital A value is 1 by 2a. Similarly, if you take the x equals to minus a, x equals to minus a, we can get the b value is minus 1 by 2a. B value, we can get minus 1 by 2a. So therefore, what is actually given question? Integration 1 by x square minus a square into dx equals to, we are taken at is a by x minus a plus b by x plus a. So integration a by x minus a to dx plus b by x plus a into dx. But what you got the a value here? Substitute here a value. A value we got here 1 by 2a and b value we got is here minus 1 by 2a. X value is the a value is 1 by 2a, b value is minus 1 by 2a. So 2a, this is the law. Look at here. This is in the form of f dash of x by f of x. F dash of x by f of x. Integration f dash of x by f of x. It is always log f of x. Yesterday we learned the formula is here. Integration f dash of x by f of x is the log f of x. Why? Because your x, f of x value is x minus a. What is the f dash of x is here? F dash of x is x derivative is 1 and a is a constant, its derivative is 0. F dash of x is both the terms in the form of f dash of x by f of x. So integration of f dash of x by f of x is log f of x. So look at here, this is the, so again I am taking the 1 by 2a common. So 1 by 2, when you take the 1 by 2a common, log of x minus a minus log of x plus a plus c. So it is a form of, look at here, it is a form of log a minus log b. Log a minus log b is the log a by b. We have the formula. So log a minus log b form is there. So that's why log a by b. So therefore, we can write this as into form of 1 by 2a into log of x minus a by x plus a plus c. Plus c. Therefore, hence proved. Therefore, integration 1 by x square minus a square into dx equals to 1 by 2a into log of x minus a by x plus a plus c. This is also important formula. Example 3, show that integration 1 by under root of a square minus x square, a square minus x square into dx equals to sine inverse of x by a plus c. So look at the LHS. Integration 1 by under root of a square minus x square into dx equals to integration 1 by. So what I am taking is here denominator. In the denominator, a square, I am taking the common. When you take in the a square is the common, it has become now a square into 1 minus x by a whole square. So when you take the a square common, become now under root of a square my into 1 minus x by a whole square. So under root of a square value is, under root of a square value is a only. So it is become now integration 1 by a into under root of 1 minus x by a whole square into dx. So it is equation number 1. Let here also x by a equals to t. X by a value, I am taking the t. Same derivative with respect to x on both sides. You can get 1 by a equals to dt by dx. So dx equals to a into dt. Dx equals to a into dt. Let us substitute here. X by a equals to t, substitute here. And substitute the dx value also. So dx value is a into dt. Therefore, equation 1 is implies integration 1 by a into under root of 1 minus x by a whole square. It become now 1 by a, I am writing is here outside. This is now substituting is here x by a value is the t. So x by a whole square is the t square. and dx value is a into dt. Now this a get cancelled. a get cancelled. So it is just simply is simply it is the form of the, look at this. This is the form of the integration 1 by under root of 1 minus x square into dx. It is equals to sine inverse of x plus c. Therefore, it is a 1 by a into a sine inverse of t plus c. But what is the t value here? T value substitute here. So a get cancelled, sine inverse of x by a. T value is x by a because we have chosen here, we have taken or we have assumed t equals to x by a, sine inverse of x by a plus c. Therefore, integration 1 by under root of a square minus x square into dx equals to sine inverse of x by a plus c. Example 4, evaluate integration 1 by under root of 4 minus 9 x square into dx. Integration 1 by 4 minus 9 x square into dx. Look at here. So integration, what is the given question here? 1 by under root of 4 minus 9 x square into dx. What is the x square coefficient here? X square coefficient is 9. So I am taking the 9 common. When it is the 9 common taken? So if the 4 is become 4 by 9 minus x square. 4 by 9 minus x square. So square root of 9 is the 3. So I will write this is 1 by 3 is outside. So 1 by 3 outside, it is equals to 1 by 3 into integration 1 by under root of 4 by 9 can be as 2 by 3 whole square minus x square. Minus x square. Look at now. It is a form of which form this is now. Look at this. It is a form of integration 1 by under root of a square minus x square form. It is equals to sine inverse of x by a plus c, sine inverse of x by a. But a value, what is the a value is here? 2 by 3. A value is 2 by 3. A value is 2 by 3. Therefore, it is a form of, in that form, integration 1 by under root of a square minus x square into dx equals to sine inverse of x by a. So it is a 1 by 3 already is there. Sine inverse of x by a value is 2 by 3. So it is equals to 1 by 3 into sine inverse of x by 2 by 3 plus c. So we can get this is, it is a when you simplification, it is equals to 1 by 3 sine inverse of, so x by 2 by 3 it become 3x by 2 plus c. Therefore, integration 1 by under root of 4 minus 9 x square equals to 1 by 3 into sine inverse of 3x by 2 plus c. Example 5, show that under root of integration under root of a square minus x square, a square minus x square into dx equals to x by a into under root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a plus c. This is also important. We can use it as a standard form. Integration under root of a square minus x square into dx equals to x by 2 into under root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a plus c. So let us solution. To prove this, I'm taking is here x equals to a sine theta, x equals to a sine theta. So derivative with respect to x on both sides. When it is derivative, what is the become the left side is dx and right side is a constant. So sine theta derivative is cos theta. So a into cos theta. So here into d theta. Dx equals to a cos theta into d theta. Actually, this became, we can write this is the x derivative is 1, a into sine derivative is cos theta. This is the t variable with respect to x variable. That's why d theta equals to, sorry, d theta by dx. Carry the dx to the left side. So it become now dx equals to a cos theta into d theta. Therefore, take the LHS now. What is the LHS is here? Therefore, under root of integration under root of a square minus x square into dx equals to, look at here, x value we have taken a sin theta, x value we have taken a sin theta, and dx value we got here a cos theta into d theta, a sin theta whole square. So it becomes, when you simplification it is, we can get integration under root of a square minus a square into sin square theta into a cos theta into d theta. Take the a square common of within the root. So integration under root of a square common. From here, a square common from these two terms, a square common. So when you take in the a square is common, 1 minus sin square theta. So 1 minus sin square theta, what is this? Student, we know that 1 minus sin square theta is cos square theta. And the root of the a square is a. Root of a square is the a. So a into under root of cos square theta, because 1 minus sin square theta is the cos square theta, into a into cos theta into d theta. It become now a into a square, because already a into a is there, a square into under root of cos square theta is the cos theta into d theta. Cos theta into cos theta is the cos square theta. So it is equals to a square into cos square theta into d theta. But we have don't have the standard form directly, integration of cos square theta. But we can write the cos square theta can be written as 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. 1 plus cos 2 theta. So I'm writing here cos square theta is 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. So a square common and by 2 also common. A square by 2 common. So integration of 1 into d theta plus integration of cos 2 theta into d theta. So integration of 1 with respect to theta variable, it is the theta plus cos 2 theta integration is sin 2 theta by 2. Integration of cos 2 theta value is sin 2 theta by 2. And integration of 1 with respect to theta variable, that's why its value is theta plus sin 2 theta. It is equals to a square by 2 into theta as it is. Sin 2 theta can be written as 2 sin theta cos theta. Sin 2 theta, sin 2a formula, 2 sin a cos a. You know, 2 get cancelled. 2 get cancelled. What is become now? A square by 2 theta plus sin theta into cos theta. You are just typing mistake here. A square by 2 as it is there. A square by 2 into theta plus sin theta into cos theta. But what you are taking here, look at here, this is the important step is here. We are taking x equals to a sin theta. Actually, we are choosing here x equals to a sin theta. So from here, what is the sin theta value? Send the a to other side. So therefore, we got the sin theta equals to x by a. Sin theta equals x by a. So from here, theta equals to sin inverse of x by a. Sin inverse of x by a. So we got the theta value and sin theta value. We need the cos theta. So cos theta can be written as under root of 1 minus sin square theta. Cos theta can be written as 1 minus sin square theta. But sin theta value is x by a. So it is equals cos theta value equals to 1 under root of 1 minus x by a whole square. Therefore, no substitute the values. So this is the theta value. And this is the sin theta value. And this is the cos theta value. Because actually the question is the previous step, it is there. A square by 2 into theta plus sin theta into cos theta is there. So theta value we are substituting is here, sin inverse of x by a. And sin theta value substituting is here, x by a. And cos theta value I'm substituting is here under root of 1 minus x square by a square. It become now a square by 2 into sin inverse of x by a, because that means a square by 2 I am multiplying is here. A square by 2 into sin inverse of x by a square by 2 into x by a. So this is multiplying here and multiplying here. So we can get a square by 2 into sin inverse of x by a and a square by 2 into x by a. Take the LCM here. You can get a square minus x square by a square under root of a square minus x square by a square. It become now a square by 2 sin inverse of x by a. Here the root of a square is the a. So already a into a is the a square. Now a square get cancelled. Only the remaining is x by 2 into under root of a square minus x square plus c. Therefore, we got the solution of this one, a square by 2 into sin inverse of x by a plus x by 2 into under root of a square minus x square plus c. Therefore, it is the hence proved. Therefore, integration under root of a square minus x square into dx equals to x by a into under root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 into sin inverse of x by a plus c. Example 6, evaluate integration 16 minus 25 x square into dx on domain is minus 4 by 5 to 4 by 5. Look at the question. What is the given integration? Under root of 16 minus 25 x square into dx. So what is the x square coefficient is here? 25. That's why I'm taking the 25 common. When the 25 is common, it become now 16 by 25. Minus x square. It become now under root of 25 value is 5. I'm writing outside. And 16 by 25 can be written as 4 by 5 whole square. Integration under root of 4 by 5 whole square minus x square. It is the form of this form. Therefore, it is a which form is here? Integration under root of a square minus x square into dx equals to x by a into under root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sin inverse of x by a plus c form. So what is the a value is here? 4 by 5. A value is 4 by 5. So substitute the a value here. Now it become now x by 2 into under root of a square value. A square a value is 4 by 5. So a square a value is 4 by 5 whole square minus x square. Plus a square nothing but 4 by 5 whole square by 2 sin inverse of x by a value is 4 by 5 plus c. So do the simplification now. 5 into x by 2, 4 by 5 whole square is 16 by 25 minus x square plus 16 into 2 into 25 into sin inverse of x by 4 by 5 become 5x by 4 plus c. Now take the LCM here now. You can get 16 minus 25 x square by 25. Square root of 25 is the 5. Now this 5 multiply with the two terms. So 5x by 2 into under root of 16 minus 25 x square by 5. So 5 into 16 by 2 into 25 into sin inverse of 5x by 5. Here 5, 5 get cancelled. Here 5 ones are 5, 5s are. So we can get the solution here now. X by 2 into integration 16 minus 25 x square plus, and here 2 ones are 2 8s are. 2 ones are 2 8s are. So 8 by 5 into sin inverse of 5x by 4 plus c. Therefore, it is a solution of the given integration question. Go to the example 7, show that integration under root of x square minus a square into dx. In the previous question, we learned under root of a square minus x square, but here x square minus a square equals to x by 2 into under root of x square minus a square minus a square by 2 into cos h inverse of x by a plus c. A square by 2 into cos h inverse of x by a plus c. So in the previous question, a square minus x square, but here x square minus a square. Solution, let here I am taking is here x equals to a cos h theta. X equals to a cos h theta. So derivative with respect to x on both sides, we can get dx equals to cos h theta derivative is sin h theta. A sin h theta into d theta. Therefore, what is the given question in the left side is integration under root of x square minus a square into dx equals to integration under root of x value we are taken is here a cos h theta. Substitute a cos h theta. Substitute the x value is a cos h theta whole square. Nothing but a square cos h square theta minus a square and dx value substitute here. Dx value we got is here a sin h theta into d theta. Now take the a common here. From these two terms, a common, a square common, a square, when you take an a square is common, cos h square theta minus 1 into a into sin h theta into d theta. But cos h square theta minus 1 is sin h square theta, sin h square theta. So under root of a square value is the a into under root of sin h square theta into a into sin h theta into d theta. Here a into a is the a square into sin h theta into sin h theta into d theta. Sin h theta nothing but sin h square theta into d theta. Again, we don't have the standard form directly, but we have the formula here. Cos h2 theta value is cos h2 theta formula is 1 plus 2 sin h square theta. 1 plus 2 sin h square theta. Sin h square theta can be written as cos h2 theta minus 1 by 2. Substitute this value. Sin h square theta can be written as 1 cos h2 theta minus 1. Substitute here by 2. So cos h2 theta minus 1 by 2. Say write the 2 is outside now. A square by 2 into integration of cos h2 theta into d theta minus 1 into d theta. Now what is the cos h2 theta integration is sin h2 theta by 2. Integration of cos h2 theta is sin h2 theta by 2 and integration of 1 with respect to theta variable is theta plus c. Sin h2 theta can be written as 2 sin h theta into cos h theta. 2 sin h theta into cos h2 theta. So here 2 to get cancel again. Minus theta plus c as it is. But sin h theta is the sin h theta value is under root of cos h square theta minus 1. Substitute that value here. So a square by 2. A square by 2 into cos h square theta minus 1 into cos h theta minus theta plus c. But what you are taking is here x equals to a cos h theta. So cos h theta value is x by a. So theta equals to cos h inverse of x by a. Substitute all the values is here. All the values. So cos h theta value is cos h theta value is x by a whole square minus 1 into x by a minus cos h theta after simplification we can get is here a square by 2 when you take the LCM in the first term a square is the LCM x square minus a square into x by a minus cos h inverse of x by a plus c. So multiply, do the simplification and after multiplication we can get this is a square into x into under root of x square minus a square by 2 a square minus a square by 2 cos h inverse of x by a plus c. Here a square get cancelled. We can get x into under root of x square minus a square by 2 minus a square by 2 cos h inverse of x by a plus c. Therefore, it is a solution. Therefore, integration under root of x square minus a square into dx equals to x by 2 into under root of x square minus a square minus a square by 2 cos h inverse of x by a plus c. So, like this problem, we have to do one example. Integration under root of 9x square minus 25x on d on interval 5 by 3 comma infinite. What is the given question is here? Integration under root of 9x square minus 25 dx. So x square coefficient is 9. So take the 9 common. So it become now under root of 9 into x square minus 25 by 9. So root of 9 value is the 3. So 3 into under root of x square minus 25 by 9 can witness 5 by 3 whole square. Dear student, look at this in the form of the under root of x square minus a square form. So its integration is x by 2 into under root of x square minus a square plus a square by 2 cos h inverse of x by a plus c. So what is the a value here? Says yes, a value is 5 by 3. So 3 into x by 2 into under root of a square minus 5 by 3 whole square plus 5 by 3 whole square by 2 into cos h inverse of x by 5 by 3 plus c. So do the simplification, we can get this. Again, simplification, we can get this value. 3, 3 get cancelled. So after cuttings, we can get its solution is x into under root of 9x square minus 25 by 2 plus 25 by 6 cos h inverse of 3x by 5 plus c. This is the integration of the given question. Therefore, integration of under root of 9x square minus 25 into dx equals to 3x by 2. 3, 3 get cancelled. Actually, x by x into 9x square minus 25 by 2 plus 25 by 6 cos h inverse of 3x by 5 plus c. Example 9, evaluate integration e power tan inverse of x. Integration e power tan inverse of x by 1 plus x square into dx. So let tan inverse of x equals to t, I'm taking easier. Derivative with respect to x on both sides. What we can get tan inverse of x derivative is 1 by 1 plus x square. Tan inverse of x derivative is 1 by 1 plus x square into dx equals to dt. So therefore, substitute the values in the given question. So we can get, so we are taking tan inverse of x value is the t, and this total we got here dt. So it is simply transformed into integration e power t into dt. E power t into dt. What is the integration of e power t is the s e power t plus c. But what is the t value substitute here? T value substitute here e equals to e power tan inverse of x plus c. E power tan inverse of x plus c. So therefore, solution of the given question, integration e power tan inverse of x by 1 plus x square into dx equals to e power tan inverse of x plus c. Example 10, evaluate. So this is already completed. Again, 9x square. This already we completed. This is. Go to the exercise 6b. 6b. Evaluate the following integrals. Third one, in that first bit, third one, evaluate integration x by 1 plus x square into dx. So let us go to the solution. Let, I'm taking easier, 1 plus x square equals to t. So 1 plus x square equals to t. So derivative with respect to x on both sides. So dear student, what we can get the derivative of left side is yes, 2x into dx equals to dt. 2x into dx equals to dt. So we can get 2x equals to dt by dx carry the dx to the left side, send the 2 to that side, x dx equals to dt by 2. Therefore, integration x by 1 plus x square into dx equals to integration x dx by 1 plus x square. What is the x dx value is? X dx value we got here, this value is, it is equals to integration, you can get dt by 2. By what you can take an x 1 plus x square value we taken is here t. So do the simplification now, it become now, it is transformed into dt by 2 by t. So integration of 1 by t, integration of 1 by t is the log t, 1 by 2 log t plus c. So 1 by 2, what is the log t value here? Yes, 1 plus x square. 1 by 2 into log 1 plus x square plus c. Therefore, integration x by 1 plus x square into dx equals to 1 by 2 into log of 1 plus x square plus c. So 7th question in the first bit, integration sine of tan inverse of x, sine of tan inverse of x by 1 plus x square into dx. So let us again same tan inverse of x equals to t. I'm taking is here tan inverse of x. This is important 2 marks question, dear student. Let tan inverse of x equals to t. Derivative with respect to x. What we can get? Derivative of tan inverse of x is 1 by 1 plus x square into dx equals to dt. 1 by 1 plus x square into dx equals to dt. So therefore, we can write the given question into the form of sine of tan inverse of x into 1 by 1 plus x square into dx. So we got this value. This value we have taken t. It will become now integration sine t. And this total we got, this is the dt. So integration of sine t value. So it is transformed integration sine t into dt. Sin t integration is s minus cos t. So minus cos t plus c. What is the t value here? Yes, tan inverse of x. That is equals to minus cos of tan inverse of x plus c. Therefore, solution of the given question, integration sine of tan inverse of x by 1 plus x square into dx equals to minus cos of tan inverse of x plus c. First bit, 10th problem, integration 2 by under root of 25 plus 9x square into dx. So, dear student, look at this. What is the left side value? I'm sorry. Given question is here, integration 2 by under root of 25 plus 9x square into dx. So, x square coefficient, what is it given in the question is here? X square coefficient is 9. Take the 9 common out and I am writing the 2 is also outside. So 2 into integration 1 by under root of 9 by 29 into 25 by 9 plus x square. Under root of 9 value is 3. So we can write this is 2 by 3. Integration 1 by under root of 25 by 19 witness 5 by 3 whole square plus x square. Dear student, it is a form of the integration 1 by under root of a square plus x square into dx equals dx form. This is a sine h inverse of x by a plus c. So 2 by 3 sine h inverse of x by 5 by 3 plus c. So 5 by 3 can be written as, we can write x by 5 by 3 is now 3x by 5. Therefore, the solution of the given question is 2 by 3 sine h inverse of 3x by 5 plus c. Integration of 14th one, integration of cos mx into cos nx into dx. Integration of cos mx into integration of cos nx into dx. What is the given question is here? I am writing here integration of cos mx into integration of cos nx into dx. So I am multiplying the 2 and dividing the 2. So it become now 1 by 2 into 2 cos mx into cos nx. look at this. It is a form of the 2 cos A cos B. 2 cos A cos B value is cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. So this is, now we can write cos A plus B. A value here mx and B value is nx. Can write this is 1 by 2 into cos of A plus B, nothing but mx plus nx plus cos A minus B, nothing but cos mx minus nx. So cos mx plus nx, x common here, now it is now 1 by 2 into integration cos of x common, now m plus n into x dx plus integration cos m minus n x into dx. So integration of cos ax is sin ax by a. So we have the integration of cos ax, it is equals to sin ax by a. So cos ax, integration of cos ax is sin ax by a. That means sin m plus n x by m plus n plus sin m minus n x by m minus n plus c. Therefore, it is a solution of the given question. Integration of cos mx into cos nx into dx equals to 1 by 2 into integration of sin m plus n x by m plus n plus sin m minus n by m minus n into x plus c. This is the solution of the given question. Next, to second bit, evaluate the following integrals. So in the third one, integration of log of 1 plus x by 1 plus x into dx. So let log of 1 plus x equals to t, derivative with respect to x on both sides. What is the log x derivative is? Yes, 1 by x. That's why log of 1 plus x derivative is 1 by 1 plus x into dx equals to dt. Therefore, the given question can write into integration log of 1 plus x into 1 by 1 plus x into dx. So we can simply, it is, we can get this total value is the dt, and this value is t, log t into dt, sorry, only t into dt. This total value is t into dt. So t, integration of t is the t square by 2 plus c. So t value here, what is the t value is? Yes, log 1 plus x, log 1 plus x whole square by 2 plus c. Therefore, it is a solution. Therefore, log of 1 plus x by 1 plus x into dx equals to log of 1 plus x whole square by 2 plus c. Integration dx by fifth one, integration dx by 1 plus 5x. Let 1 plus 5x equals to t, derivative with respect to x, what we can get? 5 dx equals to dt. So dx equals to dt by 5. So it is transformed into integration 1 by root t into dt by 5. So 1 by 5 outside, integration 1 by root t. 1 by root t can be written as t power minus 1 by 2 into dt. Integration of t power minus 1 by 2, nothing but t power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by minus 1 by 2 plus 1. So 1 by 5 into t power 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus c. So this become now 1 by 5 into 2 into t power 1 by t can be written as root t plus c. So 2 by 5 into t value substitute here 1 plus 5x plus c. Therefore, it is a solution of the given question. Therefore, dA integration dx by under root of 1 plus 5x equals to 2 by 5 into under root of 1 plus 5x plus c. Ninth one, integration cos x by 1 plus sin x whole square into dx. So I am taking here 1 plus sin x equals to t, derivative with respect to x on both sides. What is the one derivative is? 0. Cos sin x derivative is cos x into dx equals to dt. Therefore, the given question, you can write like this. It is just transformed into we got this value is, we got this cos x into dx value is dt, and this is so 1 plus sin x value, we have taken t, so it become now integration dt by t square. T square can be written as t power minus 2, 1 by t square can be written as t power minus 2 into dt. Integration of t power minus 2, nothing but t power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1. It become now, this simplification, after simplification, we can get minus 1 by t plus c. What is the c? T value substitute is here. Yes. T value is minus 1 by 1 plus sin x. T value here in this question, 1 plus sin x plus c. Therefore, this is the solution of the given question. So, dear student, I am going to conclude today's session by giving the assignment of homework. Show that integration 1 by a square minus x square equals to 1 by 2a log of a plus x by a minus x plus c. The first problem we can solve by using the partial fraction method. Integration 1 by under root of a square plus x square dx equals to sin h inverse of x by a. So how you can do this problem? Take the x equals to a sin h theta. X equals to a sin h theta. By taking that, solve this. Show that one more third problem. Integration 1 by under root of x square minus a square equals to cos h inverse of x by a. Fourth one, integration of under root of a square plus x square into dx equals to x by 2 into under root of a square plus x square plus a square by 2 into sin h inverse of x by a plus c. So how we can solve this? By taking the x equals to sin h theta. Okay. Dear student, complete this homework, and I'm going to conclude today's session. Thank you one and all for this watching.